Now, welcome to everyone to the Grizzini Racing MotoGP 2022 team presentation. My name is Vanessa Guerra and I will be your host today. And for the next half hour, we're going to be talking to some key figures within the Grizzini Racing team. Of course, we'll grab a quick chat with Ducati Corse General Manager Gigi Dalinia. We will, of course, speak to both MotoGP riders. We will unveil the bike and talk to the man who is responsible for the design of the livery and much more. And please stay with us till the very end because we will be hosting the Q&A with the riders at the very end. And now, to kickstart the presentation, let's speak to the woman that has made all of this possible. So let's welcome onto the stage Grizzini Racing team owner Nadia Padovani. Please, Nadia. Nadia, thank you for joining me. Can you please take off the mask to see your beautiful face? Thank you very, very much. Nadia, we have just seen a video of Fausto. How important was it for you to keep Fausto's vision alive?
Allora, avete appena visto il video e quindi noi siamo qui per questo grande uomo, per questo grande manager e siamo qui per portare avanti i suoi progetti e i suoi sogni. E il suo sogno era quello di essere, di rientrare in MotoGP nella classe regina e quindi questo sogno, siamo qui per questo non è stato semplice arrivare a questo punto
As Nadia was just saying, obviously we have just seen the video of Fausto and obviously it's an emotional moment, but she said that it's very important for her to carry on Fausto's vision of coming back to the MotoGP class as an independent team. And she obviously says that it hasn't been an easy road to get here.
Per arrivare qui abbiamo nel 2021 abbiamo avuto un anno veramente molto difficile. È stato molto duro, abbiamo lavorato duramente e ce ne sono successi di tutti i colori e qualcosa sapete già di quello che ci è successo durante il 2021. E altra cosa che ci è capitata è stato, per dirne le ultime, che tre giorni fa la persona detta a fare il video di questa presentazione ha avuto problemi di salute, quindi non si è potuta presentare. E un altro due giorni fa che il nostro fotografo è stato
positivo.
positivo al Covid. Quindi vi lascio immaginare un po' la situazione.
As she said, obviously the 2021 season has been a very difficult one because of obviously the loss of a valued member of the Grizzini family, Fausto Grizzini. And the road has been very, very difficult. And in racing, you know, we're used to a lot of things not going the right way. And some of you might already know some of the adversities that the team has had to face throughout the last couple of months. And Nadia was saying that even just a few days ago, the videographer that was supposed to come over and help us out with the presentation, unfortunately, due to health concerns, wasn't able to join us. And even like 2 days ago, the main photographer for the event was COVID positive. So unfortunately, this is racing. These things happen and you have to adapt quite fast.
Quindi siamo qui oggi come primo team in MotoGP del 2022 a presentarci e quindi secondo me Fausto sarebbe molto felice di questo perché lui ha sempre voluto essere il numero uno e che dire,
pole position.
Esatto, siamo prime, abbiamo la prima pole position del 2022.
So absolutely, as Nadia just said, of course, Fausto would have loved the fact that the Grizzini Racing team is the very first one to do its team presentation of the 2022 season. And it's a pole position of sorts. And I think Fausto would have really enjoyed that. Nadia, I have to ask, you are making history because you are the very first female team manager in the MotoGP class. How does it feel?
Per me è un grande onore essere qui e poter condurre l'azienda di mio marito, la Grizzini Racing, ed è anche comunque una grande responsabilità, soprattutto perché saremo presenti nella classe regina in MotoGP Voglio dire, no, io spero di essere un esempio per tutte quelle donne che ambiscono a raggiungere le massime cariche nelle varie aziende e anche per quelle donne che come me hanno avuto una perdita così importante nella loro vita e comunque non si sono date per vinte, si sono rimboccate le maniche e si sono fatte forze e sono andate avanti. E non hanno mollato, insomma.
As Nadia has just said, for her it's a matter of pride to be able to be the first ever female team manager in the top class. She says the journey has not been easy because she has had to take over after Fausto, and for her it's a great honor, but at the same time it's been a very steep learning curve. And of course, she takes it on as a very important responsibility to be able to also pave the way for women in managerial positions within our sport. Nadia, what are your expectations for the team in this 2022 season?
Allora, per quanto riguarda Enea Bastianini, l'obiettivo è quello di essere protagonisti in tutte le gare del moto mondiale. E per quanto riguarda invece Fabio, quello di fare delle belle gare e di diventare rookie dell'anno.
Absolutely. As Nadia just said, her expectations for this 2022 season are, of course, for Enea Bastianini to be able to be within the top of the class and fight it out for some podium finishes. And of course, for rookie of MotoGP, Fabio Di Gianantonio, for him to be able to fight for the rookie of the year. Nadia, thank you so, so much for joining me. And I will let you go now. And the riders have been today to Borgo Panigale to visit Ducati. So let's take a look.
La bestia.
For the moment in Ducati the work is done.
So let's go back to the workshop, to Gresini Racing Workshop.
Ciao.
So thank you to the riders. And now can we please welcome on stage Ducati Corse General Manager Gigi Dall'Igna. Gigi, please, may you join us.
Ciao Vanessa, ciao to everybody.
Always a pleasure to see you, Gigi.
Thank you very much, also to me. It's a real pleasure. It's a real pleasure to be here. And, you know, now Gresini is a part of the Ducati family. And this is really important for us.
So the writers just said that they've been to Ducati and they say their job is done. But I'm curious to know, how have you seen both writers at the Valencia test? Sorry, at the Jerez test?
You know, in Jerez, you know, for sure it was a difficult day for Dija because, you know, the first approach with the MotoGP is always difficult. But anyway, I saw him very well on the bike, riding with a smile in his face. And this is really important, you know, regarding Enea, for sure, is the first time that he rode the 2021 Ducati's machine. So it was an evolution of the bike that he used in 2021. He was really happy about the first impression and the first feeling with the bike. The lap time was good. So, you know, I think that the first step of 22 season was really good.
I'm curious to know, what do you expect from both Enea and Fabio in this season?
Enea,
putting you on the spot a little bit.
Yeah. He has to continue the growth in the MotoGP. He did very well and
rookie season.
Yes, yep. In the rookie season, he was able to reach a couple of podiums, and so I expect that for sure he continue in this path. And build his talent and to grow up. So I think that he could be a real protagonist during the season. Regarding Dija, for sure, it's the first season in MotoGP, so I think that he have to do something like an air in the first season.
No pressure, Fabio. No pressure.
No pressure.
And now a question for you, because you have taken on quite the endeavor, because Ducati will have 8 bikes on the MotoGP grid this season. So yeah. What kind of support will you be providing to the Gresini Racing team?
You know, like I told at the beginning, now Gresini is a part of the Ducati family. So for sure, we will help them during the season and during the years that they stay with us. For sure, on the technical point of view, mm-hmm. but also on the human aspect, that it's anyway important to reach the results in MotoGP. So for sure, Gresini will have the full Ducati support.
You have a lot of young talent this season on Ducati bikes.
Yeah, for sure. But this is part of our strategy. And so for this reason, Gresini is really important for us.
Well, Gigi, thank you so much for joining us. And the best of luck for this 2022 season.
Thank you very much. And hello to everybody.
And now, let's take a look at the winter preparations for the Gresini Racing MotoGP team.
Venite con me.
And now let's welcome to the stage Commercial Director Carlo Merlini and Sporting Director Michele Masini, please. Gentlemen.
Ciao, Vanessa.
It's a pleasure to be with the both of you. And in a few minutes, we're going to unveil the bikes, Carlo. But I have to say, there's a lot of work that goes on behind the scenes in order to have the bikes ready, yep. Isn't it?
A lot of hard work, and sometimes can be emotionally also very difficult. It was just a year ago, we lost the man, and that created a huge empty space, you know, from a professional point of view, but also from an emotional point of view. I don't want to go into
any details.
Too personal level, but I worked with Fausto 20 years side by side. So for me, it was a friend more than just a boss. So, but, you know, today it's an important day. As you said, we are just about to unveil 2 beautiful bikes, which is, you know, the outcome and the result of a lot of work. Technically, we are kicking off the season, the 2022 MotoGP season for the Gresini MotoGP team, which is a starting point, but from behind the scenes is also an achievement, mm-hmm. you know. If we look back 10 months ago, you know, we were with nothing which could be taken for granted. we didn't know what the future was holding for us. We had a bike manufacturer to choose, a budget from sponsors to build literally from scratch after 7 years of the experience with the previous bike manufacturer. And I was impressed to see, you know, how Nadia, Luca, Lorenzo, they wanted to take over, a very brave move, somehow unexpected also, and decided to give continuation to Gresini Racing, to push Fausto's legacy to the future. And that was very important and very emotional. And from that point onward, every single team member, you know, put the best effort to make this happen. And this is important. Last but not least, I would like to spend a few words about our sponsors. It was emotional to see how they wanted to be part of this new chapter of Gresini Racing with commitment, spirit of partnership. You know, we call them the pool of our sponsors. We call it Gresini family. You know, which I think that's the two words that embodies really the spirit of partnership that comes from every single sponsor of the Gresini team.
Spending the last couple of days with the team has made me really truly realize how there is this very family feeling within the team. And speaking of family, Michele, you've been in the team quite a few years, haven't you, before becoming the sporting director?
Yeah, today is a day full of emotion, especially for me because I'm here from 2008, so a lot of years. I'm young, but anyway.
And you have done many roles, correct?
Sorry?
You've done many, many,
yeah,
many
do,
positions.
I do many things, many positions. I'm so thankful with Nadia that immediately believe in me, give me this opportunity to grow up like a sporting director. Mm-hmm. But I think the most important is to keep the family all together. We build up in a bit more than 1 year a very nice group of guys. So half part of this team of 2022 will be with a Gresini family guy from many years. And we put inside a new guys with a lot of Ducati experience mm-hmm. behind. And of course, we have the support of, from Ducati Corse with their technician. So we will challenge from something very nice.
And what are going to be your main goals as a sporting director for Gresini Racing?
So basically, I will be the right arms of Nadia on track, and I will take care of all the sporting regulation. I take care of with our two young riders, and of course, to all the guys involved inside the garage.
Well, thank you so much to both of you for being here and for taking the time to speaking with me. And now, unfortunately, I'm going to have to switch you to gentlemen for two ladies that will be joining me now on stage. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
And now, as I said, I will be joined by two lovely ladies that will be showcasing what the Umbrella Girls are going to be looking like throughout this 2022 season. Ladies. There is a very special collaboration between Gresini Racing's team owner Nadia Padovani and Italian fashion entrepreneur Elisabetta Franchi that have designed this very unique look for the Umbrella Girls that we will be seeing throughout this 2022 season. Unfortunately, Elisabetta couldn't join us today for the team presentation, but she has left us a message, so let's take a look.
Sono molto orgogliosa di avere, molto, molto orgogliosa, lo dico tre volte, di avere collaborato col team Gresini, perché in un mondo prettamente maschile, qui parliamo del MotoGP, anche noi donne, finalmente, insieme a Nadia, facciamo la differenza. Vestire le ombrelline per me è stato uno step in avanti, perché finalmente anche queste donne avranno un qualcosa di speciale sulle piste. E non voglio svelare troppo perché lo farà il team dopo o lo ha già fatto, ma non vedo l'ora che sia il 6 per ritrovarci tutti in Qatar e per svelarvi cos'è per me la femminilità ai box di piloti che guidano moto.
Thank you so much, Elisabetta. Looking forward to see you in Qatar. So now that we've seen the look of the Umbrella Girls, and it's almost time to unveil the livery of the 2022 season for the team. But before that, I'm going to ask the Gresini Racing MotoGP riders to join me on stage. Enea, Fabio? Thank you guys for joining me. How are you?
Good. Fine. Good. Really good.
Yes? Good. Okay, well, it's now time for the unveiling of the 2022 livery. So let's go. Official livery for the 2022 season. And I have to ask, obviously, to the riders first, what do you guys think of your bikes?
Well, it's amazing. Senza moto stiamo.
Also, for me, it's amazing. It's a very strange color, but I like a lot.
It's definitely going to be easy to spot you guys from the helicopter point of view, huh? Once you're out on track, for sure.
For sure.
So, Enea, I'm going to start with you. Because obviously it's going to be your second season in the MotoGP class, and as Gigi was saying earlier, you have already 1 year of experience that you're going to be building on. And in a way, it's like coming back to the family because you've been a previous Gresini Racing in the past.
Yeah, you know, it's a pleasure to be here again with my first family in the World Championship with Gresini. Unlucky without Fausto, but with the same spirit, and this is very important for you, for all the team. And I am very happy to start again this season. And we want to arrive in the must front possible. Every race, I want to battle for the top five.
Absolutely. And I have to ask something, because you both have been teammates in the past. So how does it feel to have him back in the pit box?
Yeah, also this is strange, no? Because
I think I was first time 15 years ago, something like this.
In Valencia, I did the wild card in the 2015, I think.
Yes.
And Fabio is a very fast rider, and I think he's competitive also this year.
Yeah.
This is it's difficult.
Okay, someone is feeling the fire.
Later I pay you for these things. Thank you.
I have to say, obviously, Nadia has very high expectations for the both of you. But she said she's expecting to see you fight for podiums every now and then. What are your expectations for the season?
Yeah, my expectation is to be on the front all the race. Because we can do this. The team is incredible. We have tried for the first time in Jerez, and we are staying so fast from the start. And Nadia, I have a lot of expectation from me and also for Fabio. And I want did my maximum for this.
Well, thank you, Enea. And Fabio, switching up to MotoGP is not the only change you've had this season. There's been a number change.
Yeah, because I always use the 21, but this year I could not use it because, you know, Morbidelli has the 21, so I had to do a big change. And I choose the 49 number because I did a little research, let's say. And the 49 number has never been used in MotoGP, I think. So I will try to make history, you know, not only using this number, but trying to put this number on top. So yeah, it will be a huge step for me. Yeah, also, you know, MotoGP. So it's a big, big new challenge, a new world for me. Yeah.
As a MotoGP rookie, you must be really looking forward to your first race weekend. How does it feel now that you still have to wait a little bit?
Honestly, I can't wait many things. I can't wait to go to Malaysia to ride back this beast, my baby. And also, I can't wait to be on the grid in Qatar. I can't wait to start work with an unbelievable group of guys. They are amazing. We did the first test in Jerez. It was super, super cool. Super cool, honestly. I'm a bit nervous right now because this is a dream come true. And to ride with this team that believed in me since the day zero, and with this bike, with these new colors, all the history behind this is amazing for me. I really look forward to go racing.
And just like Enea said earlier, you are both coming full circle because you started off in Moto3 without wildcard with the Grassini team, and now you're going to go to the MotoGP class with Grassini, with an 100% Italian team, with an Italian bike. That must be pretty special.
Yeah, it's special. It's really, really special because, as I said, Fausto believed in me since day zero. And we did everything together, first points together, first podiums together, first wins together. And now we are here together, at the end together. And we are doing the best thing in the world, I think. So special, really special.
Oh, perfect. Thank you very much.
Thank you. You
guys cannot go too far because we will be doing a Q&A session at the very end. So stay with me. And now I would like to welcome the man behind the design of the livery for this 2022 season. So can we please welcome on stage Mr. Aldo Drudi.
Oh, Vanessa. Ciao to everyone.
Ciao, Aldo.
Ciao.
So we have to ask, what was the inspiration, the idea behind this design?
You know, a big challenge because it's a strange situation. I've been working with the Grassini family, with Fausto from the beginning, mm-hmm. when he was a rider, and then when he was a team manager. And now, one more time, with the family, with Nadia, that give me one more time the trust, the in charge, to do something, to mix together the Grassini image and the Ducati image. So we take a kind of risk because the color, as you can see, is not the usual color, but...
It's bold, it's very bold.
Yes, but I think will be unique on the grid. So the two riders, they will be recognizable for sure on the grid. And what we try to do is to find one color that, in a way, have the idea of a perspective. The next Grassini.
The next chapter for the Grassini Racing Team.
The next challenge. And, you know, after the bad story that happened last year, to have a perspective is really nice. So that is the color of the higher. Is the color, is a powerful color, I think. And I hope that give energy to those guys.
Absolutely. Well, thank you so much, Aldo. And now that we've taken a look at the livery, let's take a closer look at the bike itself. Almost done with the presentation, but I would like to welcome everyone back on stage that has previously been on stage. And also I would like Ducati Corse team manager Davide Tardozzi and sporting director Paolo Ciabatte to also join us on stage for a Grassini family photo, please. We're just about to finish. We're going to take this family photo, and then we are going to have the writer's media debrief straight after. But we're going to take this obviously very important photo for this 2022 season. Go ahead, Davide. Thank you very much to everyone for joining us in this live stream of the Gresini Racing MotoGP 2022 team presentation. And before we go into the media debriefs, take a close look at the very last video.
Ciao ragazzi, sono Digia, stiamo facendo lo shooting per la presentazione 2022. Andiamo. Allora, sono le 9 di sera. Gioia, non più. Quante foto abbiamo fatto?
È arrivata la pista lì un'ora fa e noi siamo qua con i caschi, a mettere i caschi, a togliere i caschi. Ci vediamo domani alle 9 di sera, saremo ancora qui.
È 8 di mattina, iniziamo. Allora.
Hello and welcome to the first Grassini Racing MotoGP Media Scrum of the 2022 season. We will begin with questions in English. And to begin with, we will start with Tammy, please.
Hi, congratulations and happy 2022. Tammy from Israel Sport 5. I wanted to know how both of you prepared for the season with the high expectations for the next step. And I also heard, Fabio, that you had some issues with your training bike. So how did you prepare for the season without them? Thank you.
Abbiamo sentito. Si sente poco.
Sì.
Question. We will have Tammy, please. Could you please repeat your question?
Okay. Hi, I wanted to know how you prepared for the coming season with all the expectations. And DG, I heard you had also an issue with your training bike, so I wanted to know how you got along with that. Thank you, and best of luck this season.
I'm sorry. Yeah, the expectation from this season is high because the last year, especially during the last part of the season, we have did two podiums, and I have think okay, I can be competitive also in MotoGP, and for this year I have to improve because the last year I've learned a lot from the category, and now I have to be more constant during all the season, also during the qualifying, because all my qualifying last year will be there was I think a disaster, but now with this bike for me will be more easy to do a faster lap during the qualifying.
Well, for sure, the preparation for the MotoGP is a bit different comparing the Moto2, because the races are a bit longer, so also physically, I have to improve 100%, but I think I will be ready. No problem. Yeah, it will be a new challenge. So the expectations are just to learn day by day, race by race on the bike, lap by lap, and to improve, understand, taking data, taking infos, and yeah, improve. Just improve. And about my bikes, everything is fine, more or less. So now just focus on the MotoGP and to start well the season.
And now, can we please have a question from Lewis Duncan?
Hi, I have a question for Anea. You said there that the qualifying will be a bit easier with this new bike. Can you explain a little bit how the 2021 Ducati differs from the bike you rode last year? What does it feel like? You know, where is it easier?
Yeah, you know, I have tried this bike only in one track for the moment, only in Jerez. But when I tried for the first time, I have seen from the start to run more easy, more relaxed during the session. And also when you push, you can do some error. And at the end, to don't lose a lot of time, no? And this is important. But also, when I tried this, I see also more power on the braking. I can brake more later, respect the 19, and also less movement. And for the qualifying, this is a just key.
We please now have the next question from Imre Pavlovits, please.
Hi, guys. I want to continue this question of Luis to Enea. What do you think, how much more of an edge will this bike give to you compared to your last year's bike? And a question to Dija. After the first impression on the tests, what are the next points that you have to learn on a MotoGP bike to get the season started?
Yeah, when I tried for the first time the bike, the 21 bike, from the start, my feel was better when I riding the bike. And Ducati, the DNA of Ducati is incredible for me. Also, in the middle of the corner, you can do more speed, and this is important also for the race, for save better the tires. But I think this is not my best problem during the race. and nothing. I want to start this season.
Well, from the test, I understood that I think we have to improve a bit the angle in the middle of the corner. I have to trust more the tires, because with this bike it's incredible how much you can lean. And also, overall, I have to improve everything, because at the end I just done, I think, 100 of laps or something like this in 2 days. So now we are waiting for to go to Malaysia to do 7 days testing. So there I will understand more which are my weak points and which are my best points also, and working on it.
Can we have a question from Valentine, please? Next.
Hello, Enea and Fabio. Question to both of you, please. You guys have already mentioned the fact that you have raced together and as teammates quite a few times, but this year it'll presumably be a little bit different because Grassini is getting used to a new bike. It's Fabio's debut. Do you guys expect to be working closer this year than you would have in the past?
Well, I think in MotoGP overall, there is a lot of work to do already by ourselves, you know, and but we have a great relationship, so I'm sure that if I have some questions to Enea and also the same from his side, I think there will be no problems to help each other, and we have great relationship. Also, the team is a big family all together, so also the Ducati way of work is to share all the data, all the infos, so I think will not be a problem to share data, infos, and to share comments also.
Yeah, like Fabio, for me is the same. And you know, when you are a rookie, it's difficult, especially during the first three races, to understand the bike. And also, we have a lot of electronics respect the Moto3, and it's a complete different work inside the box. But yes, we have a good relationship. And we can do very well, very good races together.
Do we have any more questions in English before we go move on to Italian?
Yes. Go ahead. Greg here. Ciao, Anna. Ciao, Fabio. Quick question regarding the preparations for the season. Anna, last year, sometimes during the weekends, you were struggling with your physical condition. Fabio, for you, it's going to be your first year. What were the preparations, physical preparations? How did you change your preparations to be ready for the MotoGP this year? Thank you.
Yeah, the physically preparation is a lot of important for the MotoGP. I remember the last year in the half part of the season, I was not in the good, my film was not really good, but after I understand what is necessary to do during the winter to be more competitive in the championship, but also is not only physically, but also you have to be more prepared with the mental. And now it's I know what is the expectation for this season.
Well, for sure, when you have a new bike, you have to understand when you can relax on the bike also, and it takes time, sometimes years. But overall, the physical side is always important. From the Moto3 to the MotoGP is more or less, it has the same importance. But yeah, for sure, you have to work a lot on the cardio side, but also on the strength, because the bike it has power, a lot of power, so it pulls. And you have to push on the bike. So, yeah, overall, you have to be the best athlete you can be. You don't have to be too big for the weight, but overall, you have to be just the best version of yourself, I think.
Thank you.
For the last question, we'll have Tammy, please.
Hi, thank you. Question for both again. You both mentioned that Fausto will be in spirit with you in the garage on track. I wanted to know what advice are you carrying with you and you will go out to the track from Fausto that you received in advance. Thank you.
Yeah, Fausto was a really great person with a lot of spirit also during the weekend of the race. But I have seen the same spirit in Nadia, in Luca, in Lorenzo, Agnese, the oldest son, and Alice. And also the guys of the team are more a lot of motivated. We have a great support from Ducati, and this is the best to start the season, no? And it's a very great family. I did 3 years with the Gresini, and this is my first year, but the first time without Fausto. But I want to start this season for him. And to arrive in the best place possible for all the team.
Well, as is a thing that I already said in another interview, I think, and Fausto was always saying to me to enjoy racing, to enjoy the world of the MotoGP, because when you enjoy everything comes easier, let's say. So Fausto left this mark also in the people that are working here, and all the team, all the family also. So we keep pushing with Fausto's marks, and I think when you enjoy, everything comes easier, as I said. And I think it was a great advice that I'm understanding day by day when I'm growing up, because when I was a little kid I was just going on the bike, I push, but when you enjoy, everything is better.
Thank you very much to everyone, and now we will continue with questions in Italian. Adesso iniziamo con Giovanni Zamagni, per favore.
Sì, eccomi. Ciao a tutti. Ciao Enea, ciao Fabio. Zan. Allora, ho una domanda per Enea e una per Fabio. Per Enea, ti faccio una domanda dal punto di vista psicologico, non tecnico. Avere una moto che non è l'ultima moto ufficiale, no, della Ducati, può rappresentare in qualche maniera una scusa? Voglio dire, cioè, può essere che ti condiziona un po' psicologicamente questa cosa? E invece per Fabio volevo sapere se secondo lui secondo te Fabio hai fatto il percorso giusto per arrivare in MotoGP. Grazie, in bocca al lupo a tutti e due.
Allora, secondo me questa è una moto molto bilanciata. Quando l'ho provata ieri mi è piaciuta, come ho detto, da subito. E le prime impressioni rispetto alla vecchia sono state subito meglio in generale su ogni aspetto, quindi non sono preoccupato per quello che sarà la moto 2022, e credo che anche con questa qui potrò fare la differenza sotto certi aspetti, quindi non è una cosa che mi preoccupa.
Ma penso di aver fatto il percorso giusto, sì, perché alla fine l'importante è arrivare in MotoGP in un certo modo, e a Prodi MotoGP con una Ducati dove si può fare veramente bene, insomma, no? Cioè la moto l'ho provata a Jerez e mi è piaciuta tantissimo. Secondo me con questa moto qui, se imparassi velocemente, potrei fare già molto bene già il primo anno, e quindi il percorso è stato quello che è stato. Alla fine ci sono piloti che fanno percorsi più brevi, più lunghi, ma alla fine ognuno ha la propria storia, questa è la mia, e penso di aver fatto le mosse giuste, diciamo, dai. E adesso siamo qui grazie appunto alla famiglia Gresini e a Ducati, che ci ha dato questa opportunità, mi ha dato questa opportunità, e cercherò ovviamente di sfruttarla al massimo.
Adesso continuiamo con la domanda di Andrea Fani, per favore.
Salve a tutti, grazie per l'invito, sono Andrea Fani, Gazzetta dello Sport. Avrei una domanda per Fabio Di Gianantonio. Fabio, volevo chiederti, sembri sempre molto sicuro di te, questo certamente del tuo lavoro è una dote. Ti chiedo però se da debuttante, prima sul palco hai detto sono un po' nervoso in effetti, ecco, allora ti chiedo se da debuttante temi qualcosa in particolare, o se sia più l'adrenalina da fame di MotoGP, o magari se ci sia, non so, in qualche angolo della tua mente anche un po' di timore. Grazie.
No, in realtà non c'è troppo spazio al timore in questo mondo, secondo me. Se non credi in te stesso, se non sei tu quello a credere più in te stesso, non lo fa nessuno per te. Quindi è importantissimo che tu sia consapevole dei tuoi mezzi, del tuo talento e del lavoro che tu fai anche a casa. E quindi io sono molto sicuro di me stesso, so che posso fare bene, ovviamente ho tante cose da imparare, ho bisogno del tempo, però sono sicuro di poterci arrivare. E quello che dico, sono nervoso perché per me ovviamente, come ogni pilota, è un'emozione, no? Cioè uno è piccolino, inizia con le mini moto, cresce sognando di arrivare più vicino possibile alla MotoGP e magari un giorno provarla oppure correrci, e questo io e Nel l'abbiamo realizzato, come appunto gli altri 20 piloti che ci sono in griglia, quindi è una cosa pazzesca. Sono nervoso al fatto di vedermi in griglia, ma non nervoso in modo brutto, nervoso nel fatto che sono emozionato di vedermi in griglia in MotoGP a competere contro i migliori piloti al mondo e cercare di essere uno di quelli, quindi è più emozione che timore.
Adesso Carlo Canzano, per favore. Ci sei? Carlo? Carlo Canzano? No, allora bene, allora facciamo Matteo Nunes.
Eccolo, riattivato.
Ok,
l'audio.
Carlo.
È stato riattivato. Scusate. Piacere di vedervi. Volevo chiedere solo una cosa. Siete, a entrambi, siete stati in visita alla Ducati e al museo, che è sempre fonte di emozioni e di curiosità. Qual è la cosa che avete visto al museo, la moto o anche la situazione raccontata nei vari pannelli, che vi ha emozionato di più, che in qualche modo potrebbe ispirarvi di più e perché? Grazie.
Sì, io ero già stato prima di quest'anno al museo, però è sempre un'emozione tornarci. E per me le moto sono tutto, quindi quando vedo anche moto di 50-60 anni fa, mi faccio sempre, diciamo, i miei viaggi, dico chissà com'era guidare quella moto, e penso che ci voleva anche del pelo, perché comunque sia, quella volta la sicurezza non era quella di oggi, e ovviamente io sono sempre stato affascinato come moto stradale alla 99 mondiale. Per me è qualcosa di incredibile, però la moto è bella.
Sì, il museo è sempre pazzesco, no? Vedi tutta la storia Ducati, vedi tutti i piloti che hanno corso prima e quindi l'importanza anche di far parte di una famiglia così. E sinceramente ogni volta che vedo le moto di Bayliss mi emoziono, infatti ho sempre corso col 21 anche per lui, soprattutto per lui. Lui è sempre stato il mio idolo, quindi vedere le sue moto lì, proprio le sue con cui ha corso, con cui ha vinto gare, titoli, È sempre un'emozione, quindi ogni volta che si va al museo cerco sempre di arrivare lì, le accarezzo un pochettino e penso quanto è stato bello, insomma, correre anche con quelle moto lì.
Adesso per l'ultima domanda, Matteo Nunes, per favore.
Ciao a tutti, avrei una domanda per Enea. È vero che deve ancora iniziare la stagione 2022, ma per il 2023 c'è un mercato molto aperto e teoricamente una Ducati libera nel team ufficiale. È un qualcosa a cui pensi già come obiettivo per questa stagione, provare ad andare a prenderti quella moto, o
ma di momento c'è governata, nel senso che anzi, vivere le giornate che ci saranno tra 10-15 giorni, non vedo l'ora di iniziare il campionato, e ovviamente, come ho detto, è fondamentale la preparazione invernale, quindi è servito per, diciamo, rilassarsi e per resettare, e poi, diciamo, si vedrà durante l'anno quale sarà il mio cammino, e ovviamente a me la famiglia Ducati piace tantissimo e ci sto bene. Credo che il prossimo anno possa esserci una sella libera nel team ufficiale, però non è ciò che mi preoccupa al momento. Quello che penso di più è a far bene quest'anno, e credo che non ci manca niente per arrivare a fare delle belle cose.
Grazie.
Thank you everyone for have joined us for the first media scrum of this 2022 season. Thank you very much and see you very soon at the racetracks.
Go for it. Okay.